I am Professor Isha Mehdiratta. In today's video, we are going to discuss another important topic, which is known as carrier generation and recombination and carrier transport. Talking about carriers in case of semiconductors, the carriers in semiconductors are electrons and holes both. So let's start with the first topic for today, that is carrier generation and recombination. Carrier generation and recombination is a particular process wherein we are going to study how electrons and holes are created and how they recombine. So let's start with the basic definition of carrier generation. It says it is a process where electron hole pairs are created by exciting an electron from valence to conduction band, thereby creating a hole in valence band. What do you mean by this statement? How are electron hole pairs created? When you provide energy to electrons which are in the valence band. So from the valence band, they gain energy and move to conduction band. So an empty space is created in the conduction band, which we call a hole. So this process is carrier generation. Now let's see what carrier recombination is. It is a reverse process where electrons and holes from conduction and valence bands respectively recombine and are annihilated. So generation process is a process from valence to conduction, and recombination is a reverse process. What do you mean by the word annihilated? It means destroyed. These carriers, when they recombine, they are destroyed, means again new pairs will be generated, and this is how continuously we get the transition process. Now let's see the processes which lead to carrier generation and recombination. So starting with the first one, we have photon transition. What do you mean by the word photon? Photon means the smallest packet of light. It is known as the smallest quanta of light. Let's see what photon transition is. It is also known as direct recombination or band-to-band transition. Let's have a look at the diagram first, and then we'll discuss why is it known as direct recombination. So let's have a look at the generation diagram first. So this diagram shows the carrier generation process. EV is known as the maximum level of valence band. EC is known as the minimum level of conduction band. You can see in the diagram the yellow colored portion, which has a plus and minus that indicates a hole and electron. Combined, we call them as an electron hole constellation. Now I say that this electron, it is actually an electron only. So an electron will be in the valence band till you give energy. So when you provide energy to this electron, what happens? It makes a transition to the conduction band. So what is left behind? A hole is left behind in the valence band. So this process, it absorbs photons, that is light energy, and it moves to the conduction band. Because it directly moves from one band to the other, we call it band-to-band transition. Now let's see what recombination process is. So again, we have EC and EV, that is the respective levels of valence and conduction bands. You can see the excited electron in the conduction band. Now this electron is having energy. So this electron will come to a lower and a stable level. What will happen to the energy? It will be released in the form of light. Because it is released in the form of light, we call it as a photon transition. And you can see from the diagram that directly from the conduction band, the electron has moved to the valence band. That is the reason we say it is a direct recombination. Such a type of transition takes place in direct band gap semiconductors like gallium arsenide, gallium phosphide, aluminium gallium phosphide. Now let's see the other type of process, which is known as phonon transition. What do you mean by the word phonon? It means thermal vibrations. Wherever thermal vibration word is involved, the result will be in the form of heat. So let's clearly have a look at phonon transition. It is also known as indirect recombination or trap-assisted transition. What do you mean by the word trap? Traps are defect levels which are present in certain type of semiconductors. I can give you example, silicon and germanium. You can see these defects can be an atom dislocation, or it can be a missing atom. So that depends on the atomic constitution of these materials. Let's have a look at the generation process first. In the carrier generation process, apart from the two levels, EV and EC, we have another level which is known as ET, that is the trap level. Similar to the previous transition we discussed, we have an electron hole constellation which is there in the valence band. It will remain in the valence band till energy is given. Now suppose you provide energy to this constellation. What happens? It will gain energy and move up to a higher level. Before it reaches the conduction level, there is a trap level in between which captures the electron. Now what happens? It will be in the trap level till more energy is given. So now your electron is in the trap level. If you provide more energy, it will move to the conduction band. Just notice from the diagram that the steps involved here is two. It is from valence to trap and then from trap to conduction. And hence we say it is a trap assisted or an indirect process. Let's have a look at the recombination process. The recombination process also, it starts from the electron in the higher level, that is in the conduction band. What happens to this electron? Because it has energy, it is going to release energy and come to a lower stable level. Before this electron reaches the valence level, the trap captures it. Still in the trap level, electron is having energy. So it will release its energy and go back to the valence band where it recombines with the hole. But photons are not released in this process. The reason is, here there is a transfer of momentum, conservation of momentum leading to lattice vibrations which give us heat. And that is the reason we say that it is a phonon transition where the output is in the form of heat and not light. This is a transition which takes place in indirect band gap semiconductors like silicon and germanium. Now let us move on to second topic for today, that is carrier transport. Carriers, here we mean holes and electrons both, and transport is the movement of these charge carriers. So let's see what carrier transport is. It is a process in which the charged particles, that is electrons and holes, they move in a semiconductor. So how these carriers move in a semiconductor is what is carrier transport. Let's see what carrier transport process is divided into. It is divided into two categories. The first one of them is known as carrier drift. Drift means something that happens in the presence of electric field or in the presence of an external energy. Let's see what carrier drift is. Carrier drift means the flow of charge carriers which is due to applied voltage or an electric field. And this flow of charge carriers is what is known as drift current. So drift is a process which requires an external electric field. Let's see with the help of a diagram. In this diagram, you can clearly see that electric field is applied in one particular direction. There is an arrangement of lattice atoms also shown here. You can see from the diagram that holes are moving in the direction of electric field. And while they are moving in the direction of electric field, what happens? There is a collision with the atoms. And after a certain period of time, they become stable. They achieve an equilibrium position. Now let's see what happens to electrons when an electric field is applied. So when an electric field is applied, the electrons are drifted in the opposite direction. You can see in the second diagram here. Same as holes, electrons while moving opposite to electric field, they collide with the lattice atoms and then they reach an equilibrium position. Let's see carrier drift in detail. We have average velocity that the electrons or holes achieve due to applied electric field is what is known as drift velocity. When you apply electric field, when the electrons and holes move due to this applied electric field, they have a certain velocity. They achieve a certain velocity and this average is what is known as drift velocity. So the drift velocity due to holes is given by the equation VH is equals to mu H into E, where VH is the velocity due to holes and mu H is known as the mobility of holes. Now let's see what drift velocity due to electrons is. So due to electrons, we have drift velocity VE is equals to mu E into E, where mu E is known as the mobility of electrons. Now when we say there is a flow of charge carriers, means there is a current induced. So we define the drift current density due to holes as JH is equals to NH mu H into E, where again you have JH is the drift current density due to holes, NH is the number of holes, mu H is the mobility of holes and E is the applied electric field. Similarly, we can define drift current density due to electrons as JE is equals to NE mu E, where we have mu e as the mobility of electrons. Combining these equations, we can say that number of electrons is equal to number of holes, because the same number of electrons that move in the conduction, the same number of holes will be created in the valence band. So I can combine this equation and say that J drift is equals to NeE. I can write NH as Ne because the same number of holes and electrons are present. And we have NeE is into bracket mu E plus mu H. So this particular equation defines the total current density due to the drift of electrons and holes. Now let's have a look at the second process that is responsible for carrier transport, and it is known as the carrier diffusion process. Let's see what carrier diffusion is. Carrier diffusion. Now what do you mean by the word diffusion? This is a process which is going to take place when there is uneven concentration of charge carriers. Let me give you an example. When you dope a semiconductor, why do we dope a semiconductor? We dope it to increase conductivity. While doping, there is a possibility that one of the portion of the semiconductor is doped more, or it has more number of impurities added. So that leads to uneven concentration of the semiconductors, and this is responsible for the diffusion process. Let's see what carrier diffusion is. The current produced due to the motion of charge carriers from a region of higher concentration to lower concentration is called diffusion current. Now, because the charge carriers move from a region of higher to lower concentration, there is a flow of charge carriers, and that is the reason we say that current is induced. And this current is known as diffusion current. Let's have a look at the diagram here. The left portion of the diagram shows that there is more concentration on one side. And then what happens? More charge carriers are close to each other. Let me consider an example of, say, N-type semiconductors. So you have added pentavalent impurities. So there will be more electrons together. What happens if more number of electrons are together? They are going to repel each other. And this repulsion leads to an distributed or proper arrangement as seen in the second diagram. Or I can say the electrons repel and move on the other side. Because there is a movement of electron, current is said to be generated. And such a current is known as diffusion current. Now let's see what exactly diffusion current density is. We say that this diffusion current density is proportional to the concentration gradient. What do you mean by the word concentration gradient? Concentration gradient means over a certain length, the drop of concentration. I say here there are more number of electrons present, and here there are less number of electrons present. So electrons from this side are going to move here. So what is the number of electrons, the drop of charge carriers across a particular length is what is known as concentration gradient. And the current density is proportional to this concentration gradient, as concentration gradient for holes is given by JH is proportional to dNH by dx. And if you talk about electrons, it is given as JE proportional to dNE by dx. So current density due to holes is proportional to dNH by dx, and due to electrons is proportional to dNE by dx. Now let's see the diffusion current density due to holes. If you remove the proportionality sign, we get a diffusion constant, which is known as dH. The negative sign in this equation indicates the opposite charge of holes as compared to electrons. Let's see what the diffusion current density due to electrons is. It is JE is equals to E dE dNE by dx, where dE is known as the diffusion coefficient of electrons. Combining these two equations, we get the total current density, total diffusion current density is equals to, both the equations we can take out E common, we have dE dNE by dx minus dH dNH by dx, where dE and dH, again I would say dE is the diffusion coefficient of electrons, and dH is the diffusion coefficient of holes. The negative sign in between is just because the opposite polarity of electrons and holes. So today we have discussed how are carriers generated in a semiconductor and how are these carriers traveling or moving in a semiconductor. Hope you have understood all the topics explained today very well. Thank you.